In this video, we're going to discuss four major reasons households in forbearance will not lose their homes to foreclosure. Hey everybody, David Calhoun with eXp Realty, and today we're going to discuss four reasons why homeowners who are in forbearance right now will not be losing their homes to foreclosure. So I know there's been a lot of discussion as to what will happen once the 2.3 million households currently in forbearance no longer have the protection of the program. Some assume there could be potentially millions of foreclosures ready to hit the market. However, there are four reasons this is highly unlikely. Reason number one, almost 50% have left forbearance or already caught up on their payments. So according to the Mortgage Bankers Association, MBA, data through March 28th shows that 48.9% of homeowners who have already left the program were current on their mortgage payments when they exited. 26.6% have made their payments during the forbearance period. 14.7% brought their past due payments current, and 7.6% have paid off their loan in full. Now, this doesn't mean that the over 2 million people still in the plan will exit exactly the same way. It does give us some insight into the possibilities. Reason number two is the banks don't want the houses back. So we learned this back in 2008. The lending institutions don't want the headaches of maintaining foreclosed properties. So this time they're working with homeowners to help them stay in their homes and develop some sort of repayment plan. So as an example, about 50% of all mortgages are backed by the Federal Housing Finance Agency, which is FHFA. In 2008, the FHFA offered 208,000 homeowners some form of home retention action, which are options offered to a borrower who has the financial ability to enter a workout program and wants to stay in their home. So home retention options include temporary forbearances, they include repayment plans, loan modifications, or partial loan deferrals. These have helped delinquent borrowers stay in their homes. So over the past year, the FHFA has offered that same protection to over 1 million homeowners. Today, almost all lending institutions are working with their borrowers. The report from the MBA reveals that of those homeowners who have left forbearance, 35.5% have worked out a repayment plan with their lender, 26.5% were granted a loan deferral where a borrower does not have to pay the lender interest or principal on a loan for an agreed to period of time, and then 9% were given a loan modification. Reason number three is there is no political will to foreclose on these households. The government also seemed determined not to let individuals or families lose their homes. Bloomberg recently reported, quote, mortgage companies could face penalties if they don't take steps to prevent a deluge of foreclosures that threatens to hit the housing market later this year. U.S. regulators said the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau, CFPB, warning is tied to forbearance relief that's allowed millions of borrowers to delay their mortgage payments due to the pandemic. Mortgage servicers should start reaching out to affected homeowners now to advise them on ways to modify their loans, end quote. The CFPB is proposing a new set of guidelines to ensure people will be able to retain their homes. Hence, there are major points in the proposal. The proposed rule would provide a special pre-foreclosure review period that would generally prohibit servicers from starting foreclosure until after December 31st, 2021. The proposed rule would permit servicers to offer certain streamlined loan modifications options to borrowers with COVID-19 related hardships based on the evaluation of an incomplete application. The proposal rule wants temporary changes to certain required servicer communication to make sure borrowers receive key information about their options at the appropriate time. And the fourth reason is if all else fails, homeowners will sell their homes before a foreclosure happens. So homeowners have a record levels of equity today. No one is surprised by that. So according to the latest CoreLogic home equity report, the average equity in mortgaged homes is currently at $204,000. In addition, 38% of homes do not have a mortgage. So the level of equity available in today's homeowners is significant. Just like banks, homeowners learned a lesson from the last housing crash too. So according to Black Knight, they quote, just 1 in 10 homeowners in forbearance has less than 10% equity in their home. Typically the minimum necessary to be able to sell through traditional real estate channels to avoid foreclosure. So the bottom line is that the reports of massive foreclosures about to come to the market are highly exaggerated. As Ivy Zelman, CEO of Zelman & Associates, with roughly 30 years of experience covering the housing and housing-related industries, recently proclaimed, the likelihood of us having a foreclosure crisis again is about 0%.